Gabriel Massey for channelfireball.com, and today I'm going to be playing one of the best decks in Modern, Death and Taxes. The deck got a huge boon, was a Skyclave Apparition, the new card from whatever set that set is called, I never know. I think it's Zendikar Rising, right? It also got a Maul of the Skyclave, which is a pretty sweet equipment, and the Archon of Emeria. Archon and Maul are not played in every list. Some people like more swords, like Sword of Feast and Famine, even Sword of Light and Shadow. And there's some choices you'll find different, I guess, in other deck lists. There's a few ways to build a deck, or I guess a few choices you can make, specifically number of lands. This list I got from Spider Space. He's a streamer who plays a ton of Death and Taxes, who's played the deck even before they printed Skyclave Apparition, when the deck was not necessarily tier one or as good as it is now. And he likes the Maul, he likes a bunch more lands. The deck did well the past weekend in the challenges. There was two copies in the top eight and one copy the next day. There's, you know, it was kind of Spider Space's list. Two of these copies were like similar to that list, but the one that won the Saturday challenge was playing 21 lands and more swords. So who knows what's better, but I'm going to go with the list from Spider Space, plus his name's Gabriel too, so gotta trust him. So the card, the rest of the deck's pretty classic, I guess. It's been that way for a while. Giver of Runes, Path to Exile, and Aether Vial on the one. You've got Leon and Arbiter, which is kind of an annoying card to play against when you're playing a bunch of fetch lands and stuff. That obviously combos with your Ghost Quarters and your Field of Runes. You got the Stoneforge Mystic to get your equipments, Thalia, only three copies, and the Flicker Wisp, which can be a nightmare to play against, especially once they have Aether Vial in play. The Skyclave, four copies, and your equipments are Sword of Fire and Ice, Batterskull, and the Maul. 24 lands, Field of Runes, Ghost Quarters, one Blast Zone, one Iganjo Castle, and bunch of basic planes, bunch of canopy lands, four of them, to make up for the relatively high land count. No spell lands, and the Blast Zone I think is to help a bit against Prowess. Feels kind of sketchy. I wouldn't mind Field of Rune number four, but I haven't played the deck much, so I'll trust the expert. And then the sideboard, four Forge Tender, Mark of Asylum. His last list had two. I'm going to try one Mark, one Warship. And then you've got Gravedigger's Cage, your Graveyard Hate, was Rest in Peace, Extra Removal, and Mind Sensor for the Titan decks. Revoker for, mostly for Planeswalker, stuff like Renin 6 or Saheeli Rai, these type of cards. So my experience playing Death and Taxes is that it's a bit swingy. You can have some really absurd draws, and you can have some draws that really don't do much. Hopefully, I think Stoneforge Mystic probably makes your draws a bit more consistent, and gives you kind of more action. And yeah, I guess We'll see how it goes. It's a deck I've been talking about. I have a podcast, and every week when we talk about Modern, I mention how Death and Taxes is probably one of the best decks in the format. It keeps doing well, and it makes sense. You know, whenever I play against it, I struggle, and Skyclave Apparition is really close magic card, so we'll see. We'll see how it goes. Trophy leaders, M. Hayashi. I know they used to play Prowess decks. I'm not sure if that's still the case or they're mixing it up. Dr. Queller. I think they just play Spirits for the most part. Banned Spirits. That's actually when I was recording my video with Blue-White Control. I played against them twice and beat them twice. So I put a little wrench in their plans. But Looks like they're still going strong. I played against Nidavellir recently, I think, too. I wonder if they were not playing Blue Red Storm, but yeah, I played one more league of Modern yesterday. It was that blue-white control deck. The one was Delay and Teferi, and it didn't go super well. I went 3-2, but I felt like I lost against the good draws and the good decks, and then I mostly won when my opponents didn't draw very well or didn't play very well, etc. I lost really badly to the white-green version of Titan, was the 1-2. It's the 1-2 for 1 green. You tap 2, sack a land, get a land. And, these kind of creatures are always, it's kind of like a bit like a Dark Confident for blue-white control, right? If you don't path it right away, it's really hard to beat, because what they do is they just get a bunch of Flagstones of Trocares, so it rams them. Wow, TSP Endrake. So he's probably playing some blue pile. Is this hand decent against a blue deck? I mean, it's fine. I'm not gonna mulligan. I've got a turn two Thalia. Oh, he's been playing that blue red deck, that's right. Alright. I'm not too sure if I'm supposed to play Canyon turn one. It cost me a lot of life if I draw planes on turn two, but I'm not sure if he has Thing in the Ice in his deck, stuff like that. I don't think he does. Alright, I don't think I can do much besides just jam my creatures into his removal and counterspell. Looks like this is getting a lightning bolt. Oh, Stomping Ground. I didn't expect Stomping Ground. I wonder if it's for his sideboard, if he's playing Blue Red Splash Green, or if it's actual. Rude. Yeah. Do I get the sword into play while I can, or do I just play Flicker Wisp? I think I should just play Flicker Wisp. Ooh, I've got mismatched Field of Runes, yikes. Alright, hopefully there's no Shark Typhoon. I'm not sure what I'm supposed to do. I think I probably wanna give him more cards in his graveyard, but I'm not sure I can stop that anyways. I'm guessing he has a way to put a card in a graveyard anyways. I guess I gave him an extra mana. That's great. Fair enough. Probably he's going after Ghost Quarter and not maybe Sunbeak Canyon here. All right. Let's see what he thinks about that. Archmage Charm or no? Force of Negation too. Maybe I'm supposed to just hold it for when he stepped out. Oh, he's hard casting Force or. That's a bad sign. It probably means he feels pretty confident that all he has to do is not. All right, I want to feel it from Breeding Pool now. Maybe in his upkeep? Is that better? I don't know if I care about Breeding Pool. He's just gonna get his basic forest, which is not that great for me. Maybe I want to save it for another dual land. Doesn't look like he's playing white. So he's gonna get forest. I do have Ghost Quarter. I'm not sure. Maybe I was supposed to just Feel Over in Breeding Pool and Ghost Quarter the basic forest. Maybe that was the play. I'm not sure this is accomplishing much. I did get a Force of Negation and Snapcaster Mage, which is a nice result, but I can't really imagine I'm winning this game. Playing pretty conservatively, just not a good sign for me. Gonna do it in his upkeep. I wanna see if he does something with. Just gonna go after basic forest. Jace, thanks. Field of the Dead, not the scariest right now. It's a pretty good draw. it's 1, 2, 3, 4. Should I just ignore Field of the Dead and go after Mountain? Maybe I should have done Mountain now while he was tapped out. Alright, that kind of worked out okay, I guess. I did give him an extra, maybe that wasn't that great. You know what, maybe I should have done blue. Any basics left? No basics. Or maybe he chose not to search because he had a charm on top. Alright, giving protection from red was pretty bad. Yeah, that was dumb. That sucks. Oh, stupid. I don't know if I should just load. I guess I can do both. I can cast Flicker Wisp and load a Blast Zone. Alright, I'm gonna take it slow. I'm just gonna load up my Blast Zone and get rid of the Jace. This game's weird. I don't know what his mana situation is. I'm not sure if Blast Zone would have been better as a feel over in this game. Might have another one in here, and I would be surprised. Is Rayman and Mana Lake, but I also want to be able to sack my canyon, so I'm not sure if I should play path now or not. I think I'll play it now before he draws the cards. Couple draw steps to draw a path. Oh, that's tokens already? Wow. Sword? Wow, I'm actually one damage short of killing him. I can get them all. And equip. Wow. I'm at 8. Batterskull, a bit expensive. All right. Have to drop half, I guess. Nope. And I'm at eight. I need a Snapcaster in hand. Alright, I think I'm dead, right? Wow, so close. Maybe he had Force of Negation in hand, but. Flying first. Can I live one more turn? Mean, I guess potentially I can live one more turn. Wow, that game was close. I felt like I was never really super in it, but. Right, that's good enough. Yeah, it's close. It's pretty damn close. Alright, rest in peace seems good. Even mind sensor seems decent. Mark, just for Bolt, I don't think so. Forge Tender. He might have like Anger of the Gods and stuff. Revoker's not the worst either. What's bad in this matchup? The paths are pretty bad. Think you just maybe deal with Uro was rest in peace. What an Archon. It's kind of mopey. But it does mess with what they're doing. So what should I expect? I should expect some free mana sweepers, Anger of the Gods and stuff. I guess I have Skyclave Apparition for Uro and Renin 6 and all these cards. Think I probably still want Revoker. So I don't think I want Path. I think I want Revoker maybe. I don't think I want Mark or Forge Tender just for Bolts. I can see Forge, like one Forge Tender. Think Mind Sensor is reasonable. The Flash is kind of nice too. Probably Zarkin is just plays right into the free mana sweepers into Bolt. Maybe I'll do that instead. Kind of weird to board out Archon against a Snapcaster. Tons of non-basic deck. Yikes. A lot of lands. Alright, pretty good. Does Flicker always really do anything for me? Medium. Right. I think I want to do Stoneforge first. A Piston, Forge Arbiter as a non-bow, and then... This is where you're gonna see that I'm a noob. I'm not exactly sure which one I'm supposed to get first. If I get Batterskull and they kill Stoneforge, that's pretty bad. I'm guessing I'm supposed to get the sword. But I'm not sure. So he's fetching on his turn to play around Arbiter. Let's see. Could just play a Rest in Peace now. But I don't really need to. Could just say go. That seems kind of good. Yeah, just put my creatures into play. So, assuming he has bolts. I think I would rather if I equip Stoneforge, he bolts it in response. Not too sure. I guess I gotta start somewhere. Wow, okay, I guess his hand was trash. And maybe Forge Tender is just really good. Forge Thunder into Stoneforge Mystic makes his life kind of hell. Is Forge Thunder just better than Give Reverence in this matchup? Could see that. See Forge Thunder being better than like stuff like Mind Sensor and whatnot. Maybe Thalia's not even that great on the draw because of Ren and Six. Maybe Flicker Wisp. Flicker Wisp is just not that great, honestly. If you don't have Aether Vial, and if you already have Aether Vial, you're in decent spots. But it hits kind of hard. This Flicker Wisp, once you can protect it, is pretty good too. Decks for mana can be nice. Revoker. All right, let's do that. Yikes. That basic planes draw right up the top. I already have a hand that doesn't do too much, but turn one Aether Vial seems pretty important in this matchup. I have so many lands that do stuff too. Pretty rough. Should I even play a Give Reverence here? Not sure. Just play into his open mana. Maybe I'll just say go. No, I guess I'll just play it. Thought my keep was pretty reasonable. At least it's not Snapcaster, I guess. I was gonna do that now. I hope he doesn't have anything. Flame Slash. Wow. Okay. All right. I think I'm gonna keep Aether Vial on too. That's what most of my creatures cost. All right. I'm gonna hold on to that. Three cards in hand. I'm not going to main phase. Can search for Sanctuary and put a Flame Slash back on top. I think that's fine. I'd rather make him use that now and not like when he has an Archmage Charm and he's just going off drawing a billion cards. And he seems pretty low on resources, honestly. I kind of just want to play Skyclave here and pressure him. Alright. kind of a gamble, but I don't think I want to keep waiting. Play my ghost quarter. Ghost quarter do anything for me? Just in case he Mystic Sanctuaries, I get to ghost quarter him, and then he has to choose between like lands and keeping that card on top. I can see what I draw first. Maybe he has a Cryptic Command and I should have done it on my turn. We're both trying pretty poorly. Let's see if he's searching. He's not searching. Should I go after Field of Ruin or Colored Mana? Should probably go after some red green. So if I go after Steam Vents, he can get his basic mountain. Does that screw him over at all? Not really. I'm surprised he's doing that. Maybe he has a bunch of counter spells in hand. Should I wait? Should I wait till I can equip? Mean, we know he doesn't have Ren and Six. I guess waiting doesn't really do much for me. Probably has a Reman in hand. He wants to use. I don't understand that play. I think that play is like. I mean, he's played these X more than me recently. Still a bit surprised. Unless he has Ura in hand already, maybe? But I don't think so. Fire Spout, yeah. Not like the mall was protecting me from that anyways. That's a pretty good draw. Okay, he's doing that, so I can't equip right away, and then at least if he draws a lightning bolt or a snapcaster mage, he can still kill my apparition. What's that about? Double red? Anger of the gods? No. Oh, he had the bolt. Okay. Oh, I get the 1/1? Oh. I didn't realize that. Alright, I'm just gonna play my creature. I don't think I should wait. Alright, if I had not played it, he would have drawn 2 cards, etc. Not a land. He can just steal my creature if he wants to. This doesn't really do anything. I wonder what he's gonna do, draw cards or steal my creature. Maybe he should draw cards. Such a close game. Right, I mean, this is just legends, right? One more break. That is not a break. It's not the end of the world yet, though, but I mean, oh man. Field of the Dead, all right, that's really good for me. That's as bad as it gets. Rest in peace would be nice. Any creature would be nice. Does that do it? Protection from blue, right? All right, nice. Token's blue. Just attack him. That's funny, yeah, the tokens blue. Alright, GG's. Oh, that was close. Alright. That was a close one. Crazy first match. Alright, round two, let's see. Well, I still get your attention. I'd like to give a shout out to the sponsor, Ultimate Guard. They have some of the best sleeves, the katana sleeves, best sleeves out there for a lot of people. They have also a lot of great deck boxes, something like They were kind enough to send me some of it a while ago, but I didn't get to use them yet. It's like super nice boxes, you know, you open them, they're super nice outside, super nice inside, fits for their deck box. They've got stuff like little notepad, digital notepad, and just super, super good quality product in general. If you're looking for, you know, spend a little money to protect your decks and your collection and stuff, your cube, you should check out ultimateguard.com. And yeah, they just have pretty awesome product. Honestly, I can't wait to use them. Not sure when that will be, but looking forward to it. All right, on the play, pretty great hand. White short, but maybe I'll draw into it. Man, that was such a sick first match. He just had so many draws where he could just a new row, a jace, and it was like so bad for me. And I was kind of flooding in the meantime. Alright, the last video I kind of watched when, before recording this video, I went back and watched a bit of Spider Space last stream playing this deck, and apparently he was struggling against red-black red-black storm or red-black prowess, so we'll see how this match goes. I think he was also saying he mulliganed 5 a lot, which obviously doesn't help. I don't mind that too much. I feel like it's like kind of an attrition based matchup anyway, so. Alright, I do mind. Okay, I'm gonna have to draw white. Source of white. I mean, I can Arbiter and Scorder them, but then I'm just gonna die to their Skyclave. I think I have to go Scorder myself for white here. And put an Arbiter in play. And path the Scourge. And I can't get a land. Alright, it wasn't great that to do that, but I don't need that many lands, honestly. I have Aether Vial in play. Yeah, that game would have been a bloodbath if I'd drawn a white in the first couple turns. I guess maybe my hand wasn't that good at double Thalia. Thalia dies easily though. Could be nice to have the backup one. Be pretty amazing if they don't have a removal spell for Arbiter somehow. Looks like they do. Maybe it's Slavidart. I'm guessing if it was Bolt, it would be a no-brainer for them. Alright, it is Slavidart. I see I have Lurrus to worry about at some point. Path costs 2 mana, but it's fine. This is still a better way of doing it. Alright, the question is, do I path Soulscar Mage or do I save it for Lurrus? Or it's not that scary right now. I just don't have anything to get back from the graveyards. Yeah, I think that Soul Scar Mage is gonna be a problem. I'm just gonna do it now. Alright, interesting spots. So Skyclave, which I don't want to play right away. I'm gonna keep it on too. Rewarded. So I get to get Sword of Fire and Ice or Batterskull or probably Batterskull. Ah, they drew the bubble. Oh, that is brutal. Oh, man. I mean, that would have been a lot of damage from the. I would be at 11. I would be taking like another 2 or 3 damage this turn. Tough, tough, tough. It's got to be Batterskull. Even though in the long run, maybe something else is better. Alright, what about now? Still on 2, probably, right? Because I just have way more 2s. Nope! That's so lucky. Definitely meant to, That was pretty great. Definitely meant to keep it on 2. Sometimes you get rewarded with the misclicks. I'm already tapping Sunbaked Canyon to is that a dead giveaway that they drew a lightning bolt or something? Oh, okay. All right, so put Batterskull in play. Flicker Wisp. Yes. Think this is good. Maybe you could save it for to playing Batterskull. Also, I just don't know how my cards work. I should have done it in the second main. Whoops! Making the mistake so you don't have to. Happy I can help. So if I attack here, it's a pretty hefty commitment. Alright. Alright, well, that was a huge pun because if I had done it when I was supposed to do it, I could have just hard cast a maul here or a swords. Ooh, swords a bit greedier. I think the maul might just be better, honestly. Oh yeah, they were just dead, right? If I had played that right, I would just maul the germ and 6/6 in the air. Oh, that's unfortunate. Could end up losing this game. Obviously, I'm ahead right now, but they have Valor's Bubble going, and if they have a bunch of removal on the top of their deck, they might just be fine. Wow. That sucks. That really sucks. Oh, well, also here to learn, right? Not exactly a modern expert these days. Never know if I should have chat and game log open. I think I'd rather have chat and game log open, but I don't know if for the viewers it's like better to have that open. Maybe you want to be also to follow along. Alright, hopefully they just make it easy on me and just scoop. And I don't have to worry about which plays I have to make. Even here, like, should I sack silent clearing? Might not be the worst. I think that might be the play. They are dismembering the germ token. Okay. I'm kind of in a tricky spot here. Do I just sack Silent Clearing maybe? I think that might be the play. I could like bounce Batterskull, but then it'd have a removal for Stoneforge. Alright, they're tapped out. That changes a lot. So they're gonna go up to 7. And I'm kind of tempted to just bounce Batterskull, kind of go with the sure play. Because if I sack. If I sack clearing and then break a bunch, I could get severely out tempoed. Alright. I'm just gonna do that. I'm down to 6. Wow, they just draw Fatal Push. I'm basically dead. Should just not attack. Funny too, if that was a Sword of Fire and Ice, that'd be game over too. I made some outright mistakes and then had like a few tough choices. The game would have like never been close if they didn't have Bubble right after I have some of their stuff. Wow, they just have it. Sucks. All right, well. Another Battle Rage, I guess. Alright, if they have Battle Rage. Is that a block that maybe keeps me alive? Apostle's Blessing. Okay. All right. I guess they didn't have like anything better they could have done. Alright, so I can play Arbiter and put Skyclave in play with Stoneforge. I can hard cast Thingy and have. Alright, let's see it. Not over quite yet, obviously. Looking good again, though. All right, we got there. All right, so that's the matchup for it. That as well. I think Warship's supposed to be good against them. I don't know about wins. Maybe wins. Maybe the first Rest in Peace is decent. Let's see what's bad. I don't know if he does board out Aether Vial in these matchups. Palutena's pretty bad against Lavadart. That's pretty good against them, right? Can't play more than one spell each turn. It's like kind of a must kill. Flicker Wisp is super sweet, but it's Lavadart fodder, so I'm not too sure. And card like Kolaghan's Command's pretty scary. Assuming Arbiter's okay, right? Sub decks for Paps and stuff. Do I need Rest in Peace? It's really just for Lavadarts. Lavadarts, Kolaghan's Command, maybe Lurrus. But I have a lot of removal for Lurrus. Anything else? Not sure. It's a lot of cards that are. Don't do too much, though. It's a bit scary. Not gonna do Rest in Peace. And what's the next worst creature? I could board out a Vial, maybe, or board out the land. Kind of grindy matchup. Goes long. But I almost lost because I didn't have Blight early on. Maybe Field of Ruin's kind of whatever against them. Trying to Field of Ruin on the draw. Look at the sun, it's kind of shining in my face. Alright, I'll keep. Good mana. Spells, they mulliganed. Did I do Rest in Peace? No. All right, four lands. Probably want to get four lands anyways. Just need to not draw another one for the rest of the game. Looks like they have the Scourge in hand. Well, there's not too much going on. Of course, if you like the content and if you haven't done so yet, you can subscribe to the YouTube page. And we also have always lots of stuff going at Channel Fireball. You can check out channelfireball.com for more articles, more videos. If you're interested in top-notch deck guides and sideboard guides, you can sign up for CFB Pro, which gives you access to the vault with deck guides from, you know, some of the best players like Huey Jensen, Andrea Mengucci, Lee Scott Vargas, Reed Duke, Martin Giusa. They've got almost pretty much every major archetype covered, whether it is standard or modern, a really comprehensive database. And they also update these lists whenever there's major changes, so we try to keep it up to date. CFB Pro is a really great offer. It's either $5 a month, or you can pay $10 a month and have access to like $10 a month for a year. So it's like, I think $100 for the year, and you get $10 back in store credit every month. So really good value if you plan on buying cards anyways. With CFB Pro, you also get access to the CFB Pro Showdown. It's a monthly tournament that's free to enter if you're a CFB Pro, and you get to play for, I think first it's $300 in store credit if you beat the end boss. I think this month, I think actually it's CFB Pro is happening right now. I think these videos go up on Saturday, and this month's CFB Pro Showdown is November 7th, so today's this week's end boss is LSV. If you win the tournament, you get the $300 in store credit, and then you get to play against either LSV or Huey, maybe me at some point, like kind of the end boss. And if you beat the end boss, you get to double your store credit, so that's pretty cool too. Yeah, honestly, pretty much nothing but good feedback on the CFB Pro memberships. So definitely check it out. All right, get rid of the huge death shadow. Nothing they can do if you kill the apparition in response. You straight up don't even get the 1/1 back. Ooh, that's kind of spicy, actually. They are down to 5 though, but oh, maybe I used the wrong removal. Maybe I should have used Skyclave on Lurrus and save wins for 6 mana. I was thinking I didn't want to take too big of a creature. I mean, that was short-sighted. Alright, don't want to sack my own clearing. Don't want to Ghost Quarter or land while they're tapped out. Alright, so Teemer Battle Rage is lethal. I'm not sure if they leave Teemer Battle Rage in against a deck with a lot of removal. Seems like it's a bit tough to maybe piece everything together. Can I beat a Teemo Battle Rage? Unclear. Clearly they have something. Alright, I think I should draw first, see what's up. So let's see, what if I block Soulscar Mage and have Teemo Battle Rage? That's only 19 actually.
If they have a removal spell, I'm pretty screwed either way, right?
They have a removal spell. Teemo Battle Rage 16, 20, 22.
If
block one, it's only 19. If I chump one, all right, I think, all right, what if they don't have Battle Rage and they just have a blocker or removal spell? Can I beat one removal spell? I don't think so. So I can't beat removal spell, but I can beat Battle Rage. So maybe I should double block. All right, I hope my reasoning's not flawed here. Well, this is awkward. It's just, wait, did they Battle Rage there? Okay, they Battle Rage to Death Shadow. All right, well, they had it. I was not winning here. I wasn't even getting 6 mana for Winds of Abandon, actually. But, yeah. All right, that was pretty impressive. I thought I was in really good shape. They kind of had it all, though. All right, Death Shadow is a problem. I don't think Flicker Waste would have really saved me here. Valia becomes a bit better on the play. It is nice that I have no Lavadar targets, though. And I like all my other creatures. Alright, I think I'm going to stick with this plan, even though Thalia's pretty tempting on the play. Well, that was the game where they mulligan to, right? I guess my hand was a bit slow and I flooded. Alright, Forge Tender plus Stoneforge Mystic. Kind of what I want to see. They're mulliganing again. Looks like a pretty great hand. All right, hand does nothing. And rip. Arbiter would have been a nice draw here. I was debating whether or not I should use Skyclave if I didn't draw a second one, for instance. I think I would have done it. Just basically trying to beat them down. Oh my god, did I really just do that? I'm gonna lose my Forge Tender. Well, I guess it was not that much I could have done about it, right? I mean, I guess I could have just never attacked with my Forge Tender. Well, I was totally like zoned out. It's not the end of the world, I guess. Archon or Skyclave? You just Skyclave for now? What do they have in hand? We know they have spells. Could be like Battle Rage or Apostle's Blessing or Mutagenic Growth. I kind of want to do Skyclave first. Take less damage. Obviously, Swiftseer is not their greatest creature, but I have so much removal anyways. I'll just do Skyclave first. I'm going to Skyclave something. I'd rather it be a one drop. Alright. Fine by me. So the Archon next turn is nice. If they put Lurrus in their hand and then they plan on doing Lurrus Bubble, that kind of works out. Pretty happy with any draw step here. Land is good. Spell is probably good. I just scooped. Weird. All right, nice. Close matches. Assuming this hand is good. I mean, I'm sure there's some matchups where Skyclave Apparition doesn't do anything, but another new promo, by the way, at Channel Fireball. We have something called the Ultimate Magic Gift Box, and it's something Channel Fireball is doing for the holiday season, and the box costs $49.99, $50. And you get a package with magic goodies that are typically worth like over $100. So if you think that's something you might be interested in, or maybe if you wanna looking for a gift idea for the holidays, for Christmas, you should check it out. It's called the Ultimate Magic Gift Box. And there's free versions. I think maybe there's a bunch of tiers. There's also new player gift box and a commander player gift box. So lots of sweet gifts ideas for the holidays. That's something that's pretty new. And of course, always you box it, we buy it. If you're looking for a really easy way to sell your cards, you just pack them in a box, fill up a form, just a few questions. Yikes. That's some kind of control deck. That's not what I want to see. But yeah, just send your cards, Channel Ball, they sort them for you, they price them for you. You don't have to do any of the work. You're like, just send it all in a box and they figure it out for you, send you back an offer. You're obviously free to refuse the offer, and I'm just going to play it now, try and get in and play it. And, you know, if you accept the offer, great. If you refuse the offer, they send you back the cards free of charge. So, yeah, you box it, we buy it. All right. So, maybe Omnath, maybe straight Jeskai. Wow, that's a pretty great one. Oh my god, I can't cast Sword now. Awkward. Alright. Oh, that was a disaster. I got so excited. And the reasoning was like, well, yeah, so they can't remand, they don't have the mana to remand. But if I play Thalia, then I can't play my Sword, so it was kind of awkward. And I decided it was better to play the Sword, ultimately. I see playing the Sword first, and then having a Thalia in play would have been nice, but oh well. At least I get rid of the Jace. Oh man, that's yeah. Alright, let's move on. Happens. Alright, so I should play Thalia first in case they have. Force of Negation. It's kind of not too bad for me. Let's see, they might have a Cryptic Command. I think I should halt Skyclave Apparition. The thing about Sword of Fire and Ice is it protects you from the blue token that Skyclave gives. Alright, who should I equip it on first? Skyclave? Does that make sense? I guess I'm gonna make them use a removal with a rudder. Alright, I guess it didn't really make much of a difference. Man, that one turn. My chance to out-tempo them, and I just totally blew it. I've seen Wildfire pretty good in this matchup. Alright, kind of just have to start putting creatures out there and hoping this somehow I don't have removal. Aether Vial's one of the most annoying creatures to deal with. Gee, I wonder if that's gonna stick. Shocker. Yeah, right now they could run out of gas. Snow-covered plains, by the way. I'm assuming at some point Yeah, Sunborn Spider Space was playing the removal on Thin Ice. Maybe it's to like represent that. Obviously, if you don't have snow covered plains, you'll need them in this deck. All right, that's a Mystic Sanctuary. That's land. Because they don't have a draw two in the yard, it's just like a one for one. They're probably going to put a... surprised they're not just putting a Helix back on top there. Might mean they already have a removal in hand already. Because or else you probably want to have a removal, instant speed removal ready, right? This is a mess. Alright, which one's which? So the question is, do I jam Flicker Wisp and put a sword on it? But as I said, I feel like if they didn't do anything, they already have a removal spell, so I think I'm just going to save it. Try and get some value out of it. It's a pretty annoying draw. Sword of Fire and Ice. Alright, I'm going to go ahead and... use Flicker Wisp here, since it'll fizzle their Teferi, and that means that's a 2-for-1. I just need to take my... I mean, that was the plan with Flicker Wisp, right? Getting a 2-for-1 at some point, so... Sure, this is fine. Kind of interesting they didn't do Lightning Helix. It's not a good sign. Probably means they have something good in hand. Aether Vial's just super obnoxious on the Magic Online, unfortunately. Alright, that's probably game. Yeah, they're so far ahead. I'm just gonna put back a path on top, probably. Lightning Helix, sure. I'd probably just do path, I don't know. I think Helix is probably pretty safe too. I wonder how much of a difference that turn would have made if I played it a bit better. Batterskull. Alright, I guess I should do it now. Just hard cast Batterskull. I think that means they're Lightning Helix. Not technically dead. They'd have like all lands, all the way in. They let you have a Scalding Tarn in play, so I think that's kind of compromised. I think I'm just dead on boards. Played the matchup from the Jeskai side and I lost. I think it was actually one of my CIB videos when I was playing this deck. I got paired against Death and Taxes a bunch. I think maybe I got paired against Death and Taxes twice and lost twice. I don't remember, but didn't feel super good. It's a lot about the early turns, though. It's a lot about if the Death and Taxes kind of put you in the vise in the early turns and like make you play the entire game kind of off. Off tempo in some ways. Giver of Runes, does that do anything? I don't think so. So this is like aspiring spike list. I'm gonna go see what I need to worry about. What's this latest list looks like? Oh yeah, is Madcap Experiment and Platinum appear in this sideboard? Is that good against me? Skyclave doesn't deal with it. Why do I have to keep Path to Exile in this matchup? I really don't want to have to do that, but if I board out all my removal. If I board out all my removal, can I beat a Platinum Empyrean? I guess I have Flicker Wisp. But I have to Flicker Wisp it and then attack them and then seems kind of complicated. Alright, what do I want to bring in this matchup? Mark is okay but not great. Like Forge Tender might be a bit better. Forge Tender is kind of okay. The first Rest in Peace could be kind of okay. I think Revoker is somewhat decent. Mind Sensor could be decent. Let's see, what's not good? Definitely not keeping four paths. Maybe two. All the creatures are pretty good. Skyclave's not the best. I think I'm gonna cut the Skyclaves. And then Forge Tender seems decent. Revoker seems nice. I kinda like Mind Sensor against the blue deck. Flash Flying. First Rest in Peace for Snap and Sanctuary, but I think I'd rather not do that. Alright, I guess I'm just going to respect Empyrean and leave in two paths. For reference, this is what I'm looking at. Latest list from Aspiring Spike. Probably what we're playing against. Unclear if my opponent has the Madcap package in the sideboard, though. Alright, this looks like a pretty great hand. Is it just Batterskull? Can I do something cool if I get them all against bolts and stuff? Let's get Batterskull first. Sword. I think this is good because if they have free mana Teferi, I want to be able to flash a Revoker in response and name Teferi Time Raveler. It's maybe a bit worse if they have a sweeper. Alright, I want to just put. So that means I don't get to equip. Non-land. I guess I'll just name Jace, but I'm not sure. Alright, I guess that would be a reason to get them all against Stony Silence. So we know they're not playing the exact deck I link to. Could feel of Rune Triumph. Gonna make them choose now. Gives them an extra mana. What are they gonna do with an extra mana now? Yeah, I kind of like that. I don't know. I think it's a pretty big deal for them. Might mess up their mana. Ooh, that's a sweet art, or just saga. Path to core. Alright, nothing I can do about it. That'd be a reason to keep Skyclave in, cards like Stony Silence and stuff. So they could have Snapcaster for Path, they could have Shark Typhoon. I'm just gonna attack with the Germ here. Rip. Man, that one stony sounds so good for them. Can I even get rid of stony sounds? Is there the point in putting sword into play? I'm not sure. So sick too, because I can't even like return Batterskull to my hand. Yeah, as a kind of lesson, you know, just never board out all your Skyclaves, especially against a Fairy Tamer Elder that deck. I don't know. I mean, I think it was a reasonable assumption to sideboard against Aspiring Spike Slayer Slays, but you know. I mean, they have Jace, they have Teferi, you have decent targets for Skyclave. It's a bit. I just don't like having these reactive cards in my deck. I like being able to, like, dump my hand and. But I guess, worst case, you play it as a 2/2 for free. Sometimes it's all you need, but you only need a creature to equip. Alright, I don't know what they have, but I can't play around much here, so I'm just gonna attack and hope for the best. I don't think the best is happening though. It could have been worse. All right, there's Teferi in play. Oh, I might just scoop, honestly. Don't think I can win. All right, that's a bit rough. Probably have like one Stony Silence in their sideboard and probably only works because I'm an idiot and I board out my Skyclaves. Right, GG's. That's beating. That was beating. Yeah, I mean, it's a lot about the early turns. If you can get a good land and Arbiter draw, or if you can kind of use Vial and Flicker Wisp to save your cards and kind of slowly snowball with your annoying creatures. That Stony Sounds is just way too good. It's also hard to know without, hard to play without knowing their exact list, if they have a bunch of sweepers or not, if it's Verdict, if it's Anger, if they have Madcap. Winning a lot of die rolls. All right. An honest hand. So they don't have Bolt. I'm just gonna attack. Not sure what I'm up against. They could have path, but they'd have to path me on turn two. Is that big of a problem, really? Just dumb beatdowns, I guess. So if I sack Canyon, I could path a creature and I don't get a land. Yeah, I should probably still do it. I wish I hadn't. Let's see. So Field of Ruin here is like an expensive Ghost Quarter, which might just be good enough. Oh wow. I guess I should have played Field of Ruins before. But I feel like at the same time they probably should have Helix before I got to play the land. Alright, they can't cast Anger of the Gods. I think I got this. So they're down to 8. So I can pay for Arbiter and then Field of Ruin them. Or I can Flicker Wisp and Field of Ruin them. And I don't get a land, but who cares, right? I think that's the line. Blink a land. This way they count Anger of the Gods. They obviously count Verdict. It's gonna be close though. I mean, I guess they have to fetch down to 7. They need like another Shark Typhoon. They've already cycled 2. Okay. Unfortunate. I think I should play Stoneforge and get, not sure honestly. I want to say Sword of Fire and Ice, but I could be wrong. Alright, so they can't cast Verdict. Probably can't ever cast Anger of the Gods. They would need to draw exactly on like a Steam Vent. So what can they do? I think Spot Removal, like Lightning Helix, Path to Exile, all these cards. What's the best against these cards? It might just be Batterskull. How's Batterskull just a creature if they have... Not gonna work out very well for them, is it? Still don't have Verdict Mirror, right? I have a third Helix. Alright, I guess I should have gotten them all. I suck. Rough. Apparently it's just always them all. When in doubt. Alright, I have 5 cards in hand. Damn. Just gonna have a Verdict and I'm gonna lose. I kinda wanna just draw a card, honestly. They might just have Snapcaster. Snapcaster might be more likely than a Sweeper. Okay, should I get them all now, or should I double down with a Sword of Fire and Ice? They're at 2, but it gives flying. I don't know. Pro blue, pro red. Alright, I'm gonna be stubborn. Looks like the mall would have been better again, like if they have a path here. And I don't draw land. Tough. All right. Once again, can't retell which version is we're up against. I will not board out all my Skyclaves this time. I'll keep in one path. And Forge Tender. I mean, the mark could be good. We did see free helixes. Still kind of like Revoker, I think. Mark's probably good enough. I'm a bit worried they're going to be able to just bounce it when they need to bounce it with Teferi. It's kind of the nuts, potentially. Vial plus Arbiter. I don't mind running the Revoker right there, I guess. Kind of fodder. I'm just gonna name to Fairy Time Raveler, I guess. Or Jace. I'm going to do Teferi Time Raveler. It's probably the one they play the most of. But I'm not sure it's the most impactful. I'm going to play the Arbiter on my turn, but then they can just use that against me. So I need 5 mana to turn Field of Ruin in a super, super strip mine. Let's see. Is there a difference? Field of Ruin, Ghost Quarter. No, I guess I should just use Field of Ruin. Just an expensive Ghost Quarter, but I have nothing to do nothing to do with my mana anyways. So might as well do that. All right. Good call, I guess. Interesting. Put it on free, because if I draw two, I can cast it plus Ghost Quarter. Alright, do I want to kill Teferi or do I want to kill them? I don't want to kill Teferi now. They might be able to play a removal, and I'm just going to kill Teferi. Blue, white, white, red. I'll go after white, red. Huh. Great draw. Could be good at some point. Let's see. Let's see what you think about that. If you care at all. You don't. All right, I go after second source of white, first source of red, knowing I have Mark in play now, so. Up close. Red, red, red. What's red for besides the burn spells and cleansing wildfire? That's kind of it. Cleansing wildfire, big deal. Do they really need second white? Hard to say. Alright, I'll go after the red. I do have Arbiter in place, so big Cleansing Wildfire is pretty good against me right now. Just cantrip Stone Rain. I forget how the rules work if they path my Arbiter. If I get the land or not. I also want to be able to play 2-drop if I draw one. I don't want to be able to sack my clearing this turn. Not great. I could feel of ruin. I don't think I want to do that. I think I just want to start clearing right away. Chase. Do they have the Madcap sideboard? Okay. I wonder if they keep it in for the third game once I've seen it. Pretty strong combo. Probably a bit underplayed. I mean, I don't think I was in great shape this game, but definitely got me good. So I'm going to assume no sweeper. No stony silence. Alright, I guess I'm not going to do Skyclave. I might just do like all Forge Tenders though. Yeah, this one do revoke her. Maybe I won't do the mark. If I have all my Forge Tenders. I need a couple paths. Looks pretty good. Thank you. was bit medium if they have path, they get to path Forge Tender. But I'm not sure if I care that much. Pathing Arbiter. That's fine. Strip mine them right away, especially their Triumph. Wow. Attack if they have Snapcaster, I can path it. I'm not gonna do Field now because it can just pay the two. I guess I should try and save that path for Madcap now. Unless I can keep them off 4 mana. Well, little lot in the action. Quick reminder, make sure you subscribe to the YouTube page if you like the content. If you like this video, there's, you know, many more on the site. You can also check out channelfireball.com if you need magic singles or box product. If you're looking for more strategy, you know, check out channelfireball.com. If you're looking for deck guides and sideboard guides for all the major archetypes, you can look into CFB Pro. That's the premium part of the website. It's either $5 or $10 a month, depending on which formula you choose, but it's really good value, and definitely recommend it. All right, let's see. I guess drawing a card is good, just applying a bit more pressure. So, how do I not lose to Verdict? Well, they can't Verdict next turn, right? No, they cannot. Gonna have Forge Tender for Anger of the Gods. It's not a really good draw. I think I can just play pre-combat. What's the worst that can happen? They can lend them remand. I guess I should attack first. I should just not do anything. If I play Thalia, they remand it, I play it again. And they're just dead, I think. What are you trying to do? Spell Snare? So, if they have a basic, they can basic into Verdict if they have that. But if I ghost corner them into their upkeep, then I think they're screwed. Because now they have to pay two, and they're not gonna have the mana for anything. Basically trading my Ghost Quarter for two mana. Well, that's probably not very fun for them, but all right, tough. Thanks. That can be pretty oppressive, but you need everything to come together. And if it doesn't, wheels can fall off pretty fast. Probably not the greatest matchups for me either. You might have some like kind of freebie matchups, but I'm not sure what the meta is like right now. Maybe these matchups don't really exist anymore. You know, maybe something like Tron would have been pretty good, but I think Tron's pretty much non-existent. There's like Death and Taxes. There's people playing Cleansing Wildfire decks. There's some fast combo decks. So I guess Tron is almost totally out of the meta. It's Death and Taxes, Oops All Spells, Omnath and Jeskai control decks. You've got Prowess, Red, Black, and Blue, Red Prowess. Yeah, it's possible. I mean, even if it's a tough matchup, you're still, you can still do stuff. Let's see. Mulligan 6. Not the greatest hand, but I'm assuming I have to keep. Okay. I don't think I want to give them the land right away. I'll take a hit. Might not even want to have that one. Ooh. That mean they played a like pro white, pro black guy? Could be a problem. Kind of scared of giving them second black. That's what it does, right? Ferrix and Crusader. Yikes. Protection from white and red. My friend. Alright. Maybe they don't have basic swamp. That seems good against them. Maybe not as good once you already gave them an extra land though. I couldn't attack, right? Let's see. Should I Skyclave the Ranker or Skyclave the 1/1? I don't want to just Skyclave the Ranker in case they draw Crusader. As I can always do it later. Alright, I'll get the 1/1. Can flip her with Apparition and. Oh, they drew second black. Might have just scooped. Okay, weird. I feel like they could just still win if they had second black. Alright. Anything for the Crusader? Not really, right? Does Revoker do anything against them? Not sure. All right, what's really bad against them? Nothing seems that bad against them. Nothing seems that bad against them. Any thought on the draw? It's kind of awkward with my extra spells. Alright, I'll just go Thalia. Alright, pretty great hand. Not like I have a ton I can do. Oh, they have Lurrus in their deck. Wow, did I miss that in game one? Oh, I don't even have to worry about a Crusader. That's pretty awesome. Let's see how greedy I can get with holding Path to Exile. So I can play Thalia and Giver. And next turn I can have. Yeah, I mean, pathing stuff doesn't make a ton of sense when they have Nexus and Hierarch anyways. So I think I like, well, yeah, the one I kept in. All right, fair enough. They're down to two cards. Yeah. Oh, I guess I just get to chomp, right? Seems worth it, right? Sure, you could make an argument for not chomping there. It's better in the long run. Spellskite. All right. Might as well make them pay 2 life, right? Target Nexus. I'll put a counter up. All right, 2 poison counter, and they have 1 card in hand. So I just play the sword, and if they have scale up, maybe I chump. They would need to have exactly the one that's +6/+6, exile the graveyard, delve. All right, I'm not gonna play scared. I think it's more likely I'll lose the game if I log there than when they're not putting Lurrus in their hand. Do they have another failed push? No, they could have done both. Weird. Alright, let's see. Let's see why they didn't put Lurrus in their hand. Either just forgot, just on tilt. Looks like they're just on tilt, they're just done. All right. Guess I forgot about my companion before. Said really nice broad GG's. All right, GG's. All right, well, I guess I'd much rather play against Alura's version than against someone with 4 Ferrix Inquisitors in their deck. So we lost once against Jeskai, went 1-1 against Jeskai. That matchup seemed tough. I'm not sure what cards you can play in your sideboard that make the Jeskai matchup better. I know a card like Displacer, Eldrazi Displacer, can be pretty scary. They can kind of soft lock you out of the game. I'm not sure what other hate bear you can play that's good against them. Like maybe Thalia number 4 is pretty good. Think Sword of Fire and Ice is the best sword you can play, best equipment, dead and better, so you have the best ones already. Yeah, I mean, I'm no expert, so I'm not gonna suggest too many changes, but the lands felt pretty good. 22. I was only playing 22. I think Spider Space. Oh no, I was playing 24 because I moved him column. You know, there was a few games where I flooded a bit, but 24 felt pretty good. Plasm seemed kind of okay. Castle. I mean, you need some white sources. Yeah. You know, hope as usual you enjoyed the video. It was Gear Wellness Heat for Channel Fire, channelfireball.com. And yeah, you know, as usual, subscribe if you haven't done that yet. I stream pretty much every day, twitch.tv/yellowhat, if you want to see more of my stuff. And if you want to support the YouTube channel, you can shop at Channel Fireball or shop at Ultimate Guard. They both have awesome products and offers going on all the time. Yeah, thank you so much for watching. Take care, and I'll see you next time.